guys. I'm so excited to be back on Miss Amy's Learning Adventures, and I hope you'll come and join me as we learn a little bit more about ASL today. First, I'm going to teach you a very important sign that really comes in handy while you're still learning ASL, and that sign is again. You'll take one flat hand and you'll kind of curve your other to form almost like a C, and you're just going to tap one hand against the other again. And that's really useful if you need something signed again, or if you didn't really understand something the first time, you just want to sign again. And that's really helpful while you're still learning. In today's lesson, we're going to go over family signs, and trying to explain your family. Is it big, small, medium? Who's in your family? We're going to go over all of that today. First, we're going to learn the sign for boy. You're going to take one hand, you're going to bring it up to your forehead, and it's almost like you're grabbing a baseball cap. Boy. Boy. Something really important in ASL is that all of the male-oriented signs are at the top of your face, while all the female-oriented signs are at the bottom. For example, boy is up here, and girl is down here. Girl. You're going to make a fist with your thumb out, like you're giving a thumbs up, and then you're going to drag it against your jawline. Girl. Boy. Girl. Good job. Next, we're going to learn man. Man, you're going to take one hand, just like this, like you're going to tell somebody five with your hand. Five. You're going to take it up to your forehead, and you're going to go man. Man. So it travels from your forehead down to your chest. Man. Woman is very similar. You're going to take it from your chin down to your chest. Woman. Man. Woman. And there you go. Those are four simple signs to start off with. Now we're really going to get into family members. First, we're going to look at mom. Mom is very similar to woman. You're just going to tap your chin with that five fingers again. You're just going to tap your thumb to your chin. Mom. Mom. Father, again, very similar. Right up top. Father or dad. Dad. There you go. Next, we're going to look at grandma. Grandma. So you're taking the sign from mom right against your chin, and then you're bouncing it forward. Grandma. 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 And then for grandpa, same thing but with father. Grandpa. Grandpa. Next, we're going to look at sister. Do you remember the sign for girl? Remember, it's right against your jawline with that thumbs up. Girl. First, you'll sign girl, and then you're going to take your fingers. You're going to make two L's, then you're going to tap them right against each other. Girl. Girl. I'm sorry, sister. We're signing sister. Sister. Which is girl, and then these two L's. Sister. Brother, again, very similar. A lot of these signs are just recycling and reusing. So once you learn woman, man, girl, boy, you can do a lot of these signs. And hopefully that helps you remember them. So brother is boy. And then you're going to be tapping your fingers again like this. Brother. Brother. Sister, brother. There you go. Next, we'll be looking at aunt and uncle. Aunt, you're going to take an A. Do you remember the alphabet in ASL? So we'll start with A for aunt. You're going to tap it against the side of your face Right where you sign girl. Aunt. Aunt. Or aunt. Next, we're going to do uncle. What does uncle start with? Like a U. You're going to tap it right against the side of your head. Uncle. Uncle. Aunt. And what about your cousins? Well, cousins start with a C. So we're going to do a C, and you're going to do it right in the middle of your face. Cousin. Now, if you have a boy cousin, you can sign it up here. And if you have a girl cousin, you can sign it down here. There you go. Or if you just want to say cousins, that's right in the middle of your face. Because again, remember, boys are on top and the girls are at the bottom of the face. Now, how do you sign family? You're going to take two F's because family begins with the letter F. You're going to put them together so that the O's that you're making with your hands are together. And then you're going to make a circle with your fingers so that when you're done with the circle, your pinkies should be next to each other. Family. Almost like you're giving everybody a big hug. Family. Family. Now that we know the sign for family, we're going to work on answering a few questions about our family. First, we're going to answer the question, your family, who? The sign for who is made by making an L with your fingers. You're going to put the thumb against your chin and wiggle your index finger. Who? And when you're asking a who question in ASL, you want to make sure that you bring your eyebrows down and you're making a questioning face like this. ASL is a lot of fun because ASL, there's a lot of facial expressions. You really have to use your face and you have to put on your best acting skills. So asking your family who, or who is in your family in English, will look something like this. Your family who? Let's work on answering that question. Your family who? My family. And I'll talk about my family. I have a mom, a dad, a grandma. I live with my brother and my sister. In ASL, one of the rules when you're listing things, kind of like your family, you want to shift your shoulders a little bit. Mom, dad, brother, sister. You want to shift. ASL has a lot of different rules because it is a different language than English. It's a lot of fun, but we do have to remember those rules. Once we keep practicing, they'll come more naturally and you won't even have to think about it. So, let's try that again. Your family who? My family. And then you'll go ahead and sign who's in your family. It's a lot of great practice. Next, we're going to be signing the size of our family. Is your family big? The sign for big is by making your L's, then kind of curving them a little bit, and then you're gonna drag it out so that we see how big it is. Your family big? And see, I'm asking a question, so my eyebrows go down and I'm making a questioning face with my face so that we understand that it's a question. Your family big? Is your family medium? That's taking two hands, one on bottom, and you're going to tap the top right in the middle of your hand. Medium. Your family small. And when you are signing small, you want to make almost like a pouting face like this. Small. You want to kind of scrunch up your face. Small. So, again, that's big, medium, or small. Which one? This is the sign for which. Two thumbs. And then going back and forth. So, big, medium, or small? Which one are you? What's your family? Today, we're going to end the lesson with how many. This is the sign for how many. You're going to take two fists, you're going to lower them, and then throw them up, and as you're throwing them up, you're going to open your fists. How many? How many? Your family. How many? How many? Again, you're making sure that you're making a questioning face with your face. That way we know it's a question. Your family. How many? My family, there's five. Your family, how many? Do you have two people in your family? Or three people in your family? Do you have 10 people in your family? How many? I hope you learned something in our ASL lesson today, and I'm so excited to keep coming back and teaching more. Keep practicing your ASL. I'm so excited to hear about all of the practice that you've been doing. And if there's any signs in particular that you would like to know, please leave a comment or message Miss Amy, and I'll be sure to get to that. All right. Bye.